But with the good came the bad. During that time, it was Jim Crow, legalized segregation in the United States. And the manager would usher her backstage and say, do you want to freshen before the concert and change into your gown? And she would say yes. And she would walk right past the dressing rooms that had these lovely sofas and candelabras and mirrors and bathrooms. And he would open the alleyway door and he would say, all right, you get dressed and changed and use the bathroom in the alley. And the open air and the nakedness where people could see her is what she had to do and live with. And when she went, particularly even into New York, to town hall, the news articles were not flattering. They would write such things as, oh, Marion is wearing the same taffeta gown that she wore last season, was singing her Brahms as if by rote. And it's not like the family had a lot of money or means. They were doing the best they could. So it was quite discouraging for her. It was something that continued to haunt her. It was hurtful. She wrote about it in her autobiographies. And it stayed with her whole life long. Those types of horrible injustices don't leave you. They stay with you. The great Marian Anderson was able to overcome and rise above and live out her dreams of being a successful classical artist in the United States and abroad.
Hi, little one. I have someone I would like to introduce you to. This is someone who inspired me when I was a little girl. I'm hoping maybe one day she can inspire you too. Maybe one day you'll be a singer like her and your mommy. If nothing else, it'll teach you to appreciate the beauty of voice and music and grace in class. You hear that? That's the voice of Majesty.